Hi, hello friends, welcome to our channel. In today's session, we'll be seeing the next half part 2 of non-distracted testing unit 2. Question number 16, the methods and or techniques of penetrant testing are, that is liquid penetrant testing are. Option A is given as water washable technique. Option number B is given as post emulsifiable penetrant technique. Option number C is given as solvent removable penetrant technique. Option number D is given as all the above. The methods and various techniques of liquid penetrant testing are water washable technique is also used, post emulsifiable penetrant technique is also used, solvent removable penetrant technique is also used. What is water washable technique? We are applying dyes which are water washable. Some emulsifying agent will be applied after penetrant. That technique is also is used. Post means after. Solvent removable penetrant technique. Some solvents are used for removing the penetrant material. That method is also used. So water washable technique is used, post emulsifiable penetrant technique is used, solvent removable penetrant technique is used. So I'm going with option D, all the above. These three are the methods or technique used in penetrant testing. So I'm going with option D, all the above. Question number 17. Dash is a non-distracted testing to locate surface and subsurface discontinuities in parts made by ferromagnetic materials. Option number A is given as liquid penetrant testing. Option number B is given as magnetic particle testing. Which one, liquid penetrant testing or magnetic particle testing, which one is used for locate surface and subsurface discontinuities? That is, surface means on the surface, subsurface means inside the surface, that is inner surface discontinuities in parts made by ferromagnetic materials. If ferromagnetic materials is given, the you should take none other than magnetic particle testing. So if there is any word given as ferromagnetic particles for determining discontinuities in surface and subsurface of ferromagnetic particles, only one test is used, that is magnetic particle testing. The word ferromagnetic, in the word ferromagnetic also magnetism is, the word magnetism is there, so we are going with magnetic particle testing. Can also remove, keep in your mind that way also. Question number 18. The types of magnetic particle testing techniques are. What are the types of magnetic particle testing are? Option A is given as dry particle inspection technique. Option number B is given as wet particle inspection technique. Option number C is given as both A and B. And option number D is given as none of this. The magnetic particle testing is of two types. That is dry magnetic particle testing and wet particle inspection technique. So I am going with option number C, both A and B. Question number 19. The current sequence of steps involved in magnetic particle testing are. What is the correct sequence of steps involved in magnetic particle testing? Option number A is given as cleaning or surface preparation. Then after surface preparation, demagnetization is done. After demagnetization, magnetization, it is followed by addition of magnetic particles, then illumination, then interpretation, then documentation and reporting. This is the sequence of steps given in option number A. In option number B is given as cleaning and surface preparation, then demagnetization, then magnetization, then addition of magnetic particles, then illumination, then documentation and reporting, then interpretation is given. But I choose A because first we'll be cleaning the surface, that is also called as surface preparation for dust, dirt and other impurities, only for impurities. Then demagnetization is done. If a magnet is already magnetized, then, or if material is already magnetized, then we can't do this test. So we are first taking magnetization, then we'll be again magnetizing the material. After giving magnetization, that is, we'll be applying some current to electromagnets. From the electromagnet, electric current will be converted to magnetic effect. That is, when you are applying current, if magnetization is produced, that is magnetic effect is produced, will be calling at electromagnet. The device that is used for that will be called as electromagnet. In such way, we will be getting magnetization, then addition of magnetic particles. Then we will be adding some magnetic particles. The places where there are defects, they will be having some magnetic, there will be loss of some magnetic magnetism there. If there is no holes, then equal magnetism will be throughout the body, that is workpiece or any instrument to be which is being inspected. Then illumination is done. Some light source, and we are seeing it if there is any difference in magnetism. Then interpretation will be interpreting with the original one and the defect one. If there is any defects, we'll be noticing it. If there is any defects, which part it is, which part defect is there, then documentation and reporting. If there is any defects, we'll be documenting in this part there is in left corner, in that part there is in right corner, the defect is in right corner, in that part there is a defect in inner surface, that all will be noted in a particular document, separate document, and then reporting. Yeah, this is a failure piece, this is not a failure piece. This can also be used if some adjustment is made. That all will be doing in documentation and reporting stage. The correct sequence and steps involved in magnetic particle testing are cleaning or surface preparation, the demagnetization, then magnetization, addition of magnetic particles, illumination, interpretation, documentation and reporting. So I'm going with option number A. Question number 20. The types of magnetic particle testing are. What are the types of magnetic particle testing? We have, I think this question is repeated. What are the types of magnetic particle testing techniques? We saw option number A as dry particle inspection technique. Option number B is wet particle inspection technique. So I'm going with option number C, both A and B. Question number 21. The hysteresis loop shows the relationship between induced magnetic flux density B and magnetization force H. Option A is given as true. Option number B is given as false. There is a graph which called hysteresis loop, which shows the relationship between induced magnetic flux density and magnetization force. Induced magnetic flux density is called as B and magnetizing force is called H. This is the relationship between B and H is shown in a graph called hysteresis loop. So I'm going with option number A, true. This statement is correct. Okay. Question number 22. The types of magnetic field that can be established within a component are. Option number A is given as longitudinal magnetic field. Option number B is given as circular magnetic field. Option number C is given as both A and B. And option number D is given as none of these. The types of magnetic field that can be established within a component. When you are applying an electric field, a magnetic field is introduced in the material. That magnetic field can be of two types. It can be go from top to bottom along a straight line. Case if this is a magnetic particle, if you are applying electric current in these two sides, we can have in this way magnetic lines passes in this way, or in case we are having a particle, we are applying it, the magnetic waves can also pass in circular way also. Okay, these two are the types. So I'm going with option number C, both A and B, longitudinal magnetic field and circular magnetic field. Question number 23. The magnetization equipment are broadly classified on the basis of probability as. The equipment used for producing magnetism is can be classified as the basis of portability. Portability means movement. We can move or not move. So it can only be of two types only. Because one equipment will be capable of moving. One equipment has to be done as stationary, it cannot be moved, it will be so heavy. Okay, so option number A is given as portable magnetization equipment. Option number B is given as stationary magnetization equipment. Definitely one will be movable, one will be non-movable. Movable means portable magnetization equipment, other one will be stationary. Definitely another one will be stationary magnetization equipment. So I'm going with option number C, both A and B. Question number 24. The portable magnetization equipments includes. If you are moving, the moving magnetization equipment includes what? Because if there is a stationary, we will be having heavy object. But for movable, we should be using only light objects. So what are light objects can be used? They are only seeing, okay. For portable magnetization equipment is more important than stationary. So what are the equipments you are using for portable? Because portable is not that easy to make, okay. In first producing stage, So what are the instrument they kept for making it portable? That is, we are going to see here. Option number A is given as permanent magnet. Option number B is given as electromagnetic yokes. Option number C is given as prods. Option number D is given as portable coils. And option number E is given as all the above. These four are the equipments used in portable magnetization. One is permanent magnet to produce magnetism. Electromagnetic yokes. There will be some coils, prods, and portable coils. Okay, so I'm going with option number E, all the above. These four are the components in portable magnetization equipment. So I'm going with option number E, all the above. I'll say once more: permanent magnet, electromagnetic yokes, prods, and portable coils are used in portable magnetization equipment. So I'm going with option number E, all the above. Question number 25: the equipment used in determination of magnetic field strength and direction are. Question number 25. The equipment used in determination of magnetic field strength, that is magnetic field strength, how much strength this magnetic field has. If you are applying current and producing magnetic field, or using a permanent magnet and producing a magnetic field, then what is the strength and in which it passes, in which direction? Longitudinal or transverse or axial, or which, in which direction? For determining the strength of the magnetic field and it passes in a direction, there is an equipment. That equipment is what? This is a question asked. Option number A is given as Hall effect meter. Option number B is given as pi gauge. Option number C is given as qualitative quality indicator, QQI. Option number D is given as slotted strips. And option B is given as all the above. What is the equipment used in the determination of magnetic field strength and direction are? Hall effect meter is also used for determining direction and strength of the magnetic field. Pi gauge is also used. Qualitative quantity indicator, QQI, is used. And slotted strips are used. So I'm going to option number E, all the above. Hall effect meter, pi gauge, quantitative quality indicator, how much quantity and quality indicator, that and starter strips. Starter strips are some strips having some holes. Holes means slots. They are having some slots. That is called as starter strips. All these four are the devices used for determining the magnetic field and magnetic field strength and direction. Question number 26. Types of magnetic particles are. What are the types of magnetic particles? Option number A is given as iron oxide particles. Option number B is given as pure iron particles. Option number C is given as fluorescent particles. And option number D is given as all the above. The types of magnetic particles means there are three types of magnetic particles. One is iron oxide particles. Iron oxide particles can also produce magnetism. Pure iron particles also can produce magnetism. Fluorescent particles also, some fluorescent particles also can produce magnetism. These three types of particles can produce magnetism. So one is iron oxide particles, other one is pure iron particles, and one other one is the fluorescent particles. So I'm going with option number D, all the above. Question number 27. The methods used for demagnetization are. First, while you are going for a magnetic particle testing, first step is surface screening. Then it is followed by demagnetization. Okay, your demagnetization, that. For that process, demagnetization process, which are the method used? Reversing the polarity with lower level field strength, heating the material about Curie temperature. C, both A and B, and option number D is none of these. Reversing the polarity means if the direction is from north to south, if the direction of magnetic field is from north to south, we will be applying the magnetic field in south to north, so that the both magnetic forces cancel each other, and the object becomes demagnetized. That is one method used. Other one is heating the material. If you are heating a material above Curie temperature, then the metal demagnetizes. The metal loses its magnetic properties. In that way also, we are producing demagnetization. So I'm going with option number C, both A and B. Hope you guys like this video. This is the end of magnetization chapter from your unit 2. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like this video. लाइक शेयर एंड कमेंट विथ योर लाइक शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड कमेंट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग गाइस. बाय.